Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. While we're continuing our look at the Excel 2010 new features, I want to talk about conditional formatting. They made some improvements here. Let's talk about the icon sets. So we choose the row and icon sets. You'll see that there are now some new icon sets. They added the star ratings here, whether the star is completely filled in, and the kind of the up, neutral, and down triangle arrow. So those are cool. Another great improvement that we have is in the data bar. Now, data bars are basically adding a tiny little bar chart in each cell. We've had this gradient fill. There were six of those before. But they've added something new called the solid fill. So let's do that. Conditional formatting, data bars, and solid fill. Now you'll see that the solid fill actually kind of covers up the numbers, and I'm suspecting that they planned on using this when you go into manage rules, edit rule, and say that we don't want to show the value, show the bar only. Click OK, and that will prevent the numbers from showing up. You just get the little bar charts. Very, very cool way to go. Another thing they added here was dealing with negative numbers. Negative numbers always sort of cause some problems in the data bars, and we now kind of have an option of how to deal with the negative numbers. Take a look at that. You'll see that the positive numbers are showing up in green and the negative numbers are showing up in red, and we have options there. If we go into manage rules and edit the rule, we have control for the negative value in the axis. We can change the fill color. We can make it the same color as a positive bar. Also, this interesting one here that if the number is negative, they just switch it over to red but make it go left to right. Let's take a look at that. I'm sure there might be some uses for that at some point. So there you have the red number showing up, you know, indicating that it's negative. Not sure I'm a big fan of that, but you might have a use for it. So lots of big improvements there in the conditional formatting, both with the icon sets and the data bars, whether they are gradient or solid. Also the ability now to make those be negative in a different color. Very cool improvements to a feature that was introduced back in Excel 2007. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. Tomorrow, Mike Gervin and I are going to take a look at the new SPARKLINE functionality, yet another way to do small graphics right inside the cell. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.